During Japan's classical Heian period, a female oni by the name of Ushi Gozen is conceived from the unity of the two Japanese kami, Kitano Tenjin and Gozu Tenno, the oxhead heavenly king, and is sent from the heavens to be born by a human woman. She stays in her mother's womb for 3 years and 3 months before being born precisely on the day, year, and hour of the ox. The girl is born with fangs, long hair, and eyes that shine like the morning sun. Tragically, her human father, the samurai Minamoto no Mitsunaka, does not recognize the child as a human and orders her execution. Her mother, taking pity on the oni child, takes Ushi Gozen far away to Yamato and leaves her at a temple. There, she is raised in secret as a male, ensuring that history remembers her as such. Despite being an oni, Ushi Gozen proves herself both intelligent and capable, stronger than any human. Of course, she is raised, not knowing of her divine conception, only informed of her samurai father in the imperial capital. When she reaches the age of 15, a messenger from the capital visits the temple, relaying that her father now wishes for his daughter's return. After all these years, Minamoto no Mitsunaka finally acknowledges the human side of his daughter. Thus, Ushi Gozen is brought back to the capital to serve as a samurai of the Minamoto clan and is given the name Minamoto no Raiko. There, she participates as one of the clan's members under the Seiwa Genji line, the most successful line of the clan, which is impressive considering the Minamoto clan is already one of the Heian period's 4 great clans, dominating the political climate of the time. However, because she is a mix between the blood of a human and a god, she suffers in the belief that she is not a human being at all and should not be allowed to live as one. Regardless, she puts these thoughts beneath her devotion to her father's expectations and defends the capital from the likes of men and mysteries. She fights such that meeting the sunset unbathed in blood is rare. In exchange, Raiko discovers that she has amassed trusted friends, a loving family, and a younger brother. In her campaign to protect the imperial capital from threats, Raiko assembles a troop of retainers known as the 4 Heavenly Kings, consisting of the skilled samurai Watanabe no Tsuna, Urabe no Tsuetake, and Usui Sadamitsu. The last member is perhaps its most famous, Sakata Kintoki. This warrior is born with the childhood name Kintaro, as the son of Raijin, Japan's dragon-like kami of lightning, and his ogress mother on Mount Ashigara, making him the child of both a god and oni. Raijin abandons both Kintoki and his mother on the mountain. There, he's raised to battle and kill the mountain's beasts with the strength of a monster. Even at a young age, his strength allows him to easily crush boulders and bend trees. Despite this, he is kind to his mother and forms friendships with the mountain's peaceful animals. Eventually, however, his mother is slain by Raiko's retainer, Usui. Kintoki is spared and brought before Raiko herself. She takes him on as a son and teaches him how to live as a human, recruiting him as her final heavenly king. Over time, Kintoki develops the nickname Golden for his obsession with literally everything gold. Raiko is a diligent career soldier, able to maintain her composure and professionalism. That is, until matters involve her beloved Kintoki. For him, and others she finds dear to her, she harbors a maternal love that allows her to make the world her enemy if it's for the sake of her child. In fact, her entire concept of love is centered around the love she has for her perceived children. Together, Raiko and her 4 heavenly kings establish themselves as legendary warriors capable of driving away mysteries. One of their earliest exploits, strangely enough, is their effort to separate Raiko's oni form from her body. She feels that, until she rids herself of her oni heritage, she cannot be accepted as leader of the Genji. Kintoki tries to absolve her worries, but only strengthens her resolve. At Azuma no Kuni, the land that would later become Tokyo, Raiko battles against herself within deep meditation. With enough persistence, Ushi Gozen leaves her body and becomes a major threat as it manifests as an avatar of the kami, Gozu Tenno, that in part birthed her. As a result of the separation, Ushigozen conjures storms with chaotic, roaring thunder, causing the earth around them to fracture. It becomes imperative that Raiko and her kings defeat this manifestation. While they combat the Oni, Kintoki begins to understand that, should they kill Ushigozen, Raiko herself will die. The two are inseparable. To de-escalate the situation, Kintoki approaches Ushigozen and preaches of love and the bond between a parent and their child. He recalls his fond memories of being raised by Raiko as his second mother and manages to calm Ushigozen, forcing her to slumber within Raiko's body. In time, the demon Shuten Doji descends before Raiko and her retainers. She is the Oni child of Yamata no Orochi, Japan's legendary dragon with 8 heads and tails. Shuten Doji boasts her freedom as a demonic being, taking pleasure in the world of humans. Upon entering the imperial capital, Raiko restrains herself from attacking, realizing that Shuten Doji's origins are very much akin to Kintoki's, both being born of dragon gods, and the two have a history together. In their youth, Kintoki met Shuten Doji and immediately fell for her feminine beauty. They entertained one another on various occasions, with Shuten teasing him with alcohol and snacks. While their fights and drinking bouts seemed tame to her, Kintoki saw them as deadly banquets, where one wrong move could lose him an arm or a leg. After years of venturing into Kyoto to consume and pillage, the Onmyoji discover that young men and imperial princesses have been disappearing because of Shuten Doji. Thus, they employ Raiko and her heavenly kings to execute the Oni kind dwelling on Mount Oe, where Shuten Doji appears to have taken residence. Many destructive and powerful Oni gather on the mountain within a castle, prompting Raiko and her 4 heavenly kings to form an assault. While Shuten Doji is among them, their collective leader is actually Ibaraki Doji, whom Shuten regards as her equal. Between the two, Ibaraki is a raging Oni who commands the Oni to ravage ancient Kyoto, stationed out of Oe's castle. Ibaraki hails from a noble Oni bloodline and grew up through strict discipline from her mother. Thus, she holds pride as an Oni, and it is her duty to gather the last living Oni into a group, maintaining order among them by spanking them with an iron staff. She appears innocent, but is certainly one to hurt and devour humans for their blood. Despite this, she has kind intentions, merely wishing to see her sworn sibling, Shuten, smile at all times. Raiko and her party arrive at the castle dressed in monk's clothing and humor one of Shuten Doji's banquets. They spike the Oni sake with poison, a concoction called Shinpen Kidoku, forcing the beasts into a deep slumber, allowing them to be murdered in their sleep. Shuten Doji knows that her sake is poisoned, but her obsession for pleasure tempts her to at least try it. Ibaraki hears of Shuten's negligence and fails to save her. Kintoki reluctantly beheads Shuten Doji and is shocked when her still-moving lips murmur, "Guess I'll go a bit ahead of you, okay?" Kintoki looks upon the deceased Oni and regrets his foul play, wishing to meet Shuten Doji again one day. Ibaraki Doji returns to find her fellow Oni have all been killed. As the only survivor, she confronts one of Raiko's retainers, Watanabe Notsuna, at Rashomon, Kyoto's southern gate. After a grueling duel, Watanabe severs Ibaraki's right hand with his sword, Higekiri. Despite fleeing, sometime later, Ibaraki returns to reclaim her missing appendage. One of the other mysteries slain by Raiko is the giant earth spider, Tsuchigumo. While exploring a northern Kyoto mountain, the group encounters a flying skull and chooses to follow it, arriving at an old estate where a gorgeous woman tempts them. Raiko slices the woman and she vanishes, leaving behind a trail of white blood. This leads them through a cavern in the mountains, where they find a massive spider, the culprit behind the mountain's many murders. After a long bout, Raiko wins by severing the spider's head, causing its body to spew forth nearly 2,000 human heads, smaller spiders, and skulls. Minamoto no Raiko continues to protect the Imperial Capital from phantasmal entities until dying on August 29th, 1021. Her deeds are passed down in legends, describing her as a man, and collectively, she, her retainer Sakata Kintoki, Shuten Doji, and Ibaraki Doji are all recorded into the Throne of Heroes as either heroic or anti-heroic spirits. In the modern era, the Caldea Security Organization strives to resolve various singularities that emerged throughout human history. One such singularity occurs around Kyoto, Japan. Their master, Ritsuka Fujimaru, and their servant, Mashu Kirialite, discover a sleeping Sakata Kintoki among the sakura petals. He wakes up and explains that he had been wrestling bears the night before. The scent of alcohol permeates the nearby mountain in the form of a mist, and the three proceed to investigate, although Mashu becomes intoxicated and clings buoyantly to Ritsuka over every little threat. They head to the alcohol's source and find Rashomon Gate, guarded by Ibaraki Doji, who has absorbed Shuten Doji's strength during her sleep. Stronger than normal, she rampages the surrounding area, inebriating and devouring nearby villagers. Ritsuka, Mashu, and Kintoki continually battle against Ibaraki Doji and eventually exhaust her stamina, allowing Shuten Doji to awaken. They discover the cause of the singularity to be a grail filled with wine that, without restraint, Shuten Doji had tasted, falling into slumber. The grail's wine granted Ibaraki's wish to rampage with Shuten, creating a ton of trouble for everyone. Yet, more trouble brews later, as another singularity develops on the island distant from Kyoto, Onigashima. It is a fictional island, featured in the tale of Momotaro, in which the hero exchanges dumplings to earn the companionship of a dog, monkey, and pheasant, before going on to slay a demon atop the island. There, Ritsuka teams up with Ushiwakamaru, Kintoki, Fuma Kotaro, and Musashino Benkei. Conveniently, Ushiwakamaru is also one of the Minamoto clan, just like Raiko. On the island, oni are found enslaving humans into labor camps, all while Minamoto no Raiko traverses the land punishing the oni. Ritsuka's party fights their way up the island, defeating Japanese servants along the way, before reaching the grail causing the singularity. At the top, they discover that Raiko has been consumed by her oni half, Ushigozen. With the grail in her hands, Ushigozen brought the fictional island to life so that those of mixed divine blood, like Kintoki and herself, can thrive. She also admits to being the culprit behind the Rashomon incident, stemming all the way back to the interference of a demon god pillar. With her ambitions at dangerous levels, Kintoki vows to defeat Ushigozen and return her to normal. Through combat, Ushigozen is able to release plenty of divine energy, allowing Raiko to once again gain control. Feeling shameful, Minamoto no Raiko thanks Ritsuka and vows to become their sword as a heroic spirit. Through these incidents, Caldea becomes more lively. For Raiko, Ritsuka is a symbol of salvation, clearing away her inner darkness by accepting her as an ally despite her demonic being. Just as with Kintoki, she feels that their meeting as master and servant was fated. She treats the two of them like her own children. While Raiko has been summoned as a berserker with madness enhancement, she maintains her sense of reason. More specifically, her madness appears in how she is willing to brutally destroy anyone who dares threaten her loved ones. Her maternal love is left unrestrained. Raiko babies Kintoki and Ritsuka incessantly, getting angry when they miss dinner running combat simulations. She bawls her eyes out until they apologize for not being around to eat her caringly prepared meal. In fact, she learns to cook from Caldea's other two mothers, Bodhika and Emiya. In battle, Raiko wields her katana, the Dojigiri Yasutsuna, a blade forged to execute criminals, known as one of Japan's five most celebrated swords. Her noble phantasm is the Ox King's Storm Call, inescapable net of heaven. By channeling her demonic side, Ushigozen, and its link to the Kami Gozu Tenno, Raiko is able to call upon the god's divine messenger Ox to aid her in ravaging enemy camps with the summoned armaments of her four heavenly kings. When fully awakened to her Ushigozen persona, this technique is called Ox King's Power, Rising Fury. During Caldea's second summer, Raiko insists on protecting her master and the festivities by praying to Gozu Tenno and transforming her servant class into that of a lancer and participating as president of the Public Morals Committee. To maintain order, she derives power from Gozu Tenno's origin as an Indian deity, Sakura Indra, allowing her to wield her noble phantasm, Sakura's Vajra, the god's ultimate weapon, and its lightning to decimate her opponents. Kintoki, on the other hand, is reckless and childish. As a berserker, his wild impulses are front and center, despite not overriding his ability to speak and relatively moderate himself. In battle, he assists Ritsuka with his Golden Eater, Golden Eating, a large Masakari axe imbued with his father Raijin's thunder power. It is a weapon only he and his superhuman strength can handle. Using it, he can perform his noble phantasm, Golden Spark, Golden Shock, a technique that releases a surge of lightning from his weapon to mow down entire armies. In other circumstances, he can be summoned as a rider-class servant. He rides atop his Golden Drive, Golden Bear Mark I, a motorcycle also imbued with Raijin's power. According to Kintoki, the bike has 2 million horsepower and can easily reach Mach 2 speeds. Using it to its fullest, he unleashes his noble phantasm, Golden Drive, Good Night, to charge into his enemies at speeds far greater than the bike is normally capable of. Ibaraki Doji is a troublesome servant to handle. While she enjoys being fed, especially chocolate, Ritsuka must never treat her like a kind pet, for she is a wild animal, a lion. Ritsuka must remain attentive to ensure Ibaraki doesn't shift her love of treats into a craving for humans. In battle, she is armed with a massive bone sword, forged from the bones of other oni kind, imbued with curses. She possesses two noble phantasms. The first is Great Flame of Mount Oe, 10 consecutive attacks of searing heat that char her enemy's bones. Her second is Great Grudge of Rashomon, the hand that was severed by Watanabe Notsuna. She sends it forth with its flaming grip. During Caldea's exploits in Babylonia, Ibaraki Doji finds herself isolated atop Mount Ebi, and Kintoki makes a special ray-shift expedition to defeat and free her from her solitude. Despite feuding in the past, Kintoki is able to make amends with the two oni. That said, Kintoki is still hopelessly flustered when it comes to Shuten Doji's sexual advances, choosing to stray from all things intimate. Thus, Shuten Doji is far more manageable in comparison. She simply does as she pleases, often involving the seductive indulgence of potent wines. Her skill, alcoholic scent of a fruit, allows her to make others drunk simply from her gaze and voice. Despite it being the cause of her death, Shuten Doji loves the poison sake Raiko had used upon her, such that it is her noble phantasm, multitude of colors, providential oni poison. With it, she is able to release a deadly poison that both ails and decomposes her enemies. Conveniently, the pouch she carries it in can turn into a sword. As a servant for Caldea, she merely wishes to appreciate her favorite things: alcohol, flowers, pretty men, and the moon. For Halloween, she takes the form of a caster in Oniland, accompanied by a familiar named Haku, a demon from Ainu mythology. Beyond the struggles these individuals faced in life, their appearance as heroic spirits offers them a clean slate with which to confront each other on more amicable terms, united by a master who cares for them all and accepts their nature as oni kind. In return, these servants fight to protect humanity and its future. Thanks for watching. If you enjoy this channel, help me beat the algorithm by liking, commenting, and sharing the video, subscribing to Otaku Daikun, and most of all, smashing that notification bell as if it were your waifu. That way, you'll never miss out on all of my anime content, lore videos, live streams, and Holy Waifu Wars polls. My vids are struggling to get featured, so that bell is absolutely critical. If you want to support me directly, check out my Patreon, or consider donating via Super Chat. And as always, celebrate your fandom.